The ActiveCampaign integration with Salesforce deals with three of the platform's most commonly used objects, the contact, account, and lead object. This integration allows for a bi-directional syncing of data between the custom field values within your Salesforce environment and the custom field values found within your ActiveCampaign environment. This means that the information you have within both platforms will be able to talk with each other so that they are both up to date with the most accurate information. You are able to have this sync as frequently as once every hour or just a sync on a daily basis. And if you ever want to confirm that everything is syncing correctly, as it should, the integration comes with a health dashboard that would allow you to see any failed syncs as well as the API usage ActiveCampaign is using for this integration. After the installation of the integration, you will have two additional components that you have the option of adding to your lead and contact object page. The first is the ActiveCampaign Cxa component. This allows for your reps to immediately send the contact an email or enter them into an automation without having to leave their Salesforce environment. You can see when I open up these views that you have a drop-down menu of all the options for campaigns and automations that I can enter this contact into. And on the ActiveCampaign side, we can also help to add permissions if there are any certain email templates or automations that you would prefer your sales reps not to access. So if you had particular emails you wanted your sales reps to be able to utilize, but others you wanted to make sure were just for the marketing team, we can make sure that they will only see what you would like them to see. But through this functionality, you can bring the power of personalization and automation from within your ActiveCampaign account to your Salesforce team members. The second component of the ActiveCampaign Salesforce integration is the Cxa Activities. This view allows you to see all ActiveCampaign activity tracked about this record from within your Salesforce environment that involves email, automation, and web-based tracking. Any aspect with the email icon is involving email activity from within ActiveCampaign. This could be anyone who's been sent an email, opened an email, maybe clicked on a link, or had replied to that email. This could be reflecting a one-off email or any email that's sent from the ActiveCampaign automation flows. When you click on the arrow icon, it then expands further to show you what they specifically interacted with, whether that was a specific link that they had clicked on or maybe an email that they had opened. This feature is super beneficial for any sales, support, or success teams working day-to-day with your customers because while the marketing team may be familiar with the marketing and interaction potential, this often is unknown to other teams. What this allows is for them to be more connected and relevant to the customer or potential customers they may be working with within their Salesforce environment. Also within the activity feed, you should be able to see a yellow gear icon. This represents any automation flows this contact has entered into. And when you click on further details for this, you would be able to also link out to see the automation that this contact has flowed through. And finally, the purple icon here represents all site and event activity that is recorded on the contact within your ActiveCampaign environment. Should you look into the additional details for these aspects on your activity feed, it'll reflect either where they have been on your website or what they might have done within your website or signed up for through event tracking. ActiveCampaign has the ability to have great insight into how people are interacting with your business online. And now through this integration, we are able to pass this information along to your teams who are utilizing your Salesforce environment. And should you want to explore this activity feed further, you can also click on this arrow icon here to be able to view more options and more of the history feed. Likewise, you can also click on this filter icon to be able to filter out to the specific activities you're looking for, whether you just want to look at email interaction versus just wanting to look at that site activity. Now that we have reviewed all the functionality of the integration on the Salesforce side, we can switch over to the ActiveCampaign side of the integration. Within your ActiveCampaign instance, not a lot is going to change on a visual level for your contact and account records, but know that any contacts and accounts synced with Salesforce will stay up to date between the two systems. The way that you'll be able to know which contacts are synced with Salesforce is through tags that are automatically applied through this integration. These tags will tell you that the contact is synced with Salesforce and how it became synced, whether they had originally come from Salesforce or maybe they had originated from ActiveCampaign and were created as a Salesforce lead. Not only is this information good for knowledge of who's been synced with your Salesforce environment, but it can also be super insightful for reporting purposes should you want to know which system is generating more leads and/or more conversions. The final aspect to this integration can be found as an activity within the ActiveCampaign Automation Builder. No contacts within ActiveCampaign automatically get created within Salesforce. They would first need to go through an ActiveCampaign automation that has specific actions created for this integration. Those actions would either create a new lead within your Salesforce environment, or it could also create a new contact record. This barrier allows for businesses to use the unique data insight and automation capabilities of ActiveCampaign to be more selective and specific of who comes over to Salesforce for that more one-to-one communication. And as we know that this process and criteria are unique for every business, we give you the tools to create the data flow that makes the most sense for you. As you can see within this automation, the goal is to be able to send my marketing qualified leads over to Salesforce. First, when a contact interacts with ActiveCampaign, they're going to submit my opt-in form so that they can gather more information about my business. At this point in time, I don't believe that they're quite ready to get connected with my Salesforce team. I first want to make sure that they're excited about the company and are really interested before they take up my sales team's valuable time. I also want to set some foundational information about us first. So I'm going to be sending some marketing and waiting to see how they interact. You can see I have a lead score here that checks to see, are they going to my website? Are they interacting with my emails? And do they fit the profile of someone who would likely make a good customer of ours? As people are waiting, they'll be queued up into the automation until they fit that lead score for me, which equals 25 or more. If they do hit my lead score threshold, they would then hit the Create a Lead in Salesforce action within this automation and be sent over to my Salesforce environment for my sales team to now begin conversations. There are so many opportunities to add additional power to your sales and marketing efforts through this integration. With this addition, you can combine the capabilities of a personalized and data-driven marketing approach within ActiveCampaign with the flexible and automated processes of your Salesforce environment in Salesforce, and without either of them ever missing a beat. So any questions about the possibilities available within the ActiveCampaign Salesforce integration, reach out to the ActiveCampaign sales, success, and support teams, as we are so excited to get you up and running.